It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show, presented by Kia.
Welcome, NBA fans, and you know who you are. Ernie Johnson here with you again, along with Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, for what is still a very new, a very fresh NBA season. And on tap tonight, it's the Sacramento Kings going up against the Portland Trailblazers at Moda Center. Taking a look at the Trailblazers, they're off to a better start than last season, and that certainly bodes well. Always some changes from season to season, but they're going in the right direction. Looking back on the Trailblazers last year, they were a lot better than people expected them to be in the post-Aldridge era. What kept them so competitive when it should have been much more of a rebuilding season, Shaq?
Well, first of all, America, do not snub Damian Lillard again this year for the All-Star game. This guy has showed he can be a leader on the team, and that takes him to the next phase. You know, a lot of youth stepped up and performed real quicker than anticipated. This guy has been snubbed 2 years in a row, Kenny.
Our guy Dame Dalla.
Can I use my old school? No.
Go ahead. Yeah. Use your old school reporter voice to describe Damian Lillard.
Okay, let me see. Damian Lillard, I'll tell you, he's one heck of a guy. I'll tell you, one time he comes down the floor, he skips up to the light, skip to the left, skippity-doo-dop to the rim, and he scores. That is Dame Dalla. That's it. That's my last one for this.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, promises. That's it for now. We hope you'll tune in later. Although, if you don't, we understand why.
Welcome, basketball fans, to a very special Veterans Day edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan, along with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, our terrific analysts, and David Aldridge is our sideline reporter. It's Western Conference NBA action, the Portland Trail Blazers here at home. This game against Sacramento is the first time they've met this year. Last year was a lopsided affair as they were able to take all four games in the series, earning the sweep.
And they rolled over this team last season, beating them every time they faced off.
Yeah, it was a completely one-sided season series, and that was no surprise to anyone. This first game between them should give us an idea if they're on a little more even ground this season.
Now Sacramento starting five. The Wildcat pair of Cauley-Stein and Cousins are down low. Aflalo is out there with Collison. And it's Gay in at the three. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option. You know, you think about DeMarcus Cousins. Every time you feel like he's kind of nearing his ceiling, he just explodes through it. I mean, some of the stat lines he put up, they're legendary, and if he weren't already difficult enough to defend last year, he added the ability to stroke that three-pointer. I mean, you're talking about a seven-footer with the complete repertoire on the offensive end.
He's off on the second. And talking about Cousins' new outside shot, he hadn't taken more than 22 three-pointers in an entire season before last year. Huh, quite a change.
Yeah, everything Cousins is doing skill-wise on the money. Maybe you'd like for him to shoot for a higher field goal percentage, but that could be nitpicky. The important thing is the total effect he has on his team.
The Trailblazers have gone 0-4, missing their first four field goals here. Now McCollum, he had a 21-point outing in their last game against the Clippers.
It felt like in that game, too, he was a man on a mission defensively. Finishing up with four steals is an impressive feat. And you could tell, takes pride in that part of the game.
Here's Collison, following the basket by C.J. McCollum. Now the pass to Cousins. And it's sent back by Plumlee.
Big athletic guys like Plumlee, hard to get your shot over them before they can get their hands up.
Harkless kicks to McCollum. Back to Harkless. Plumlee with a screen on Gabe. Here's Harkless. Plumlee, great positioning on the putback.
And folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Collison, the pass to Aflalo. That falls. Great assist by Darren Collison. Aflalo's got his first points of the night. The Trailblazers have gone just 2 of 7 so far. A little bit of a slow start for them. Here is Lillard. He had a 21-point outing in their last game against the Clippers.
Well, the other part of his game was the menacing defense. You can tell his team really looks for him to be their junkyard dog.
Again, McCollum missing.
Outstanding D there. They really got up in his shirt and made him uncomfortable.
That one drops for him.
And how about the bounce pass there being used to perfection?
Lillard against Collison. There's the screen. Lillard dishes to Aminu.
And Al-Farouq Aminu, definitely a fit with this Blazer team as they move towards the younger players. He is just 26 years of age. He is a high-energy glue guy and has proven his worth at that position.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good.
Becoming more of a factor these days on the offensive end. Aminu, once the 8th overall player taken in a draft, getting to the line a little more often.
And good on the second, so he makes them both. The Kings trailing. Here's Cousins. Plumlee with the rebound. Plumlee's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. And you look at Aminu, he brings some versatility. He can play the 3, but he also can step over to the 4 spot if needed.
Oh, yeah, he can rebound and block shots like a power forward at times, and he can defend inside and on the perimeter. What a switchblade for their coaching staff.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And, Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
Well, it fires up your teammates and the fans when you make plays like that out in the open court and explosive.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. And a wide-open look for McCollum. Finds himself wide open and drills it.
Simply, there are nights where he becomes a scoring machine, outside, inside. It doesn't matter. You have to keep a body on McCollum at all times.
Now, here's Gabe. His last outing with 20 points. They set the screen. And Rudy Gay, extremely versatile, has the size and athleticism to play a number of positions. He produces, but for some reason, you know, Greg, people always seem to want more out of the guy.
Yeah, some of the disrespect I think he deals with is because he hasn't played on a lot of winning teams. Greater efficiency and tougher defense are a couple of areas where he's still trying to improve.
And the first one at the line is good. On that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line. And at this point of the season, Brent, it's still early, but you start to get a sense of how teams are going to play as the year goes on.
Always talk about that 30 to 35 game mark for coaches to figure out the roles of the new players and to see how far along his star players have come. This is a great opportunity for them to keep on that process and keep the growth moving forward.
One of the best parts of the season, really.
Well, when you look back for a championship team, Kevin, there are parts of the season that you can say are bookmark moments. This could be one of them.
The Kings have made 2 and missed 2 at the line tonight.
And on the season, you know, they're hitting about 76%, which is a decent rate.
And he can't get the first one. Boy, in the last year, the Kings, Greg, went all in, even trading a couple of veteran contracts to the Sixers.
Yeah, and they used the cap reshuffling to sign Kufis and Rondo, a number of others as well, at the beginning of last year. And regardless of the outcome of last season's games, those moves made this team much more competitive. And now the question is, can they build off of some of that momentum?
Good on the second free throw. Portland's gone 0 of 2 from deep here. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, I had a chance to speak with Terry Stotts. He told me he's looking forward to the matchup tonight. It's their first time against this team, so he is curious to see what his guys do on offense. He said it's important that we're aggressive defensively, that we use our length and shot blocking as a deterrent inside. We'll see if they can be successful tonight. Kevin, back to you.
Okay, Dave, thanks. So defense, it looks like, coming first for them today.
That's their identity. That's what they're all about. Their defense is really what sparks them.
Yeah, and I think they're going to have to take some chances here. Steals and blocks, anything that could spark a run for them on the other end.
Here's Lillard. After the Kings pick up 2, and Plumlee kicks to Turner. Good ball movement here by the Trailblazers. To the middle. Plumlee, the pass to Aminu, hands the 12-footer.
And this is where he can hurt you most offensively. Aminu's well-schooled in the catch-and-shoot game.
Outside Collison. Feeds it to Cousins. Plumlee with the steal. Launches it. The putback. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second-chance points.
Oh, great timing. He is one tough customer on that offensive glass.
You know, it's like he has a sixth sense of where that rebound is going. Now, here's Lillard. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. And the rejection by Cousins. Here's a Aflalo. It's stolen by Aminu. Inside, Plumlee. Nice D from Cousins.
Man, if he's missing those kind of good looks, his team is in some serious trouble.
Cauley-Stein dishes to Aflalo. Fires for 3. Good. And it's Cousins picking up the assist. And that's now 7 points for Aaron Aflalo. So timeout called here, the first for Portland. And DeMarcus Cousins, such a polarizing figure for coaches and fans alike. And this is dating back to his college days, even at Kentucky.
Yeah, maturing some, but obviously that fire burns bright within him. His passion is what helps fuel that production, especially when you start comparing him to other true centers. And a moment now to see some numbers for DeMarcus Cousins. 6th in blocks, 11th in scoring. And don't forget, top 20 in the league in rebounds per game. He's got a great nose for the ball.
Trailblazers trail by 6. And it's Plumlee that time on the assist by Lillard.
That's where Plumlee operates best. The closer to the basket, the better chance he has of converting.
McCollum against the Aflalo. Gay outside. Here's Cauley-Stein, and so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2. He's made one and missed one so far in the game.
And of course, we'd all like to see his percentage at the line improve, but he just does not have the touch right now. He's in the 60s.
And he knocks down the first one. And Blazers coach Terry Stotts doing a great job. Brent, his team has overachieved in recent seasons.
I'm not sure if it's overachieved because they've had some tremendous talent. But the interesting part about Terry Stotts is try to find him taking some of the credit for what's gone on there, and you just won't. He's just giving guys great opportunities. He's given those guys defined roles, and each one has stepped up for him. And this Blazers team, although dynamic offensively, defense is where they have the most room to improve. Don't get me wrong. They weren't awful there, but that's got to be a little bit more of their focus.
Now here's Cauley Stein. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Lakers.
I'm not sure in that game if it was him or Dikembe Mutombo out there, guys. I was just hoping to see one finger wave after one of those four blocks.
No, no, no. Not today.
Gay can't hit. You talked about the Blazers' defense. Brent, where specifically do they need to improve?
Well, there's probably two areas, Kevin, where you can be much better. First off is just positional defense, where you have guys in the right spot on possessions just to make them difficult for the offensive team. And then the second part about that is no cheap, reaching, easy fouls. Those are just bailout possessions that help out your opponent.
Now, Gabe, after the missed three from Damian Lillard. From 12 feet out, Plumlee with some nice D.
Defense did a really good job of choking off the middle there once he got inside.
Shots good by Turner. Here's Collison. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Lakers. Screen by Cousins. It's tipped. Follow against McCollum. Now here's a Aflalo. 9 points last game out. 5 to shoot. Deep two from Collison. Bank shot. No good.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
McCollum kicks to Lillard. McCollum passes to Plumlee. Aminu with it. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Clippers.
And also, he competed on the backboards. That also had a lot to do with the game.
He just doesn't seem to be himself shooting the ball right now, guys. Just looks a tad bit uneasy, and that's affecting the result.
Now here's Turner. Aaron Aflalo missing his last shot.
Just tentative in the paint, lacking a little bit of confidence, allowed the defender to recover and contest that shot.
And it's sent back by Plumlee. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Plumlee. And looking back at last season, here's a look at the three-point and two-point shot attempt averages for the Trailblazers.
And they love to spread the floor with shooting. A lot of three-point attempts, and that's been the league-wide direction, and this group has been no exception.
Timeout is called. First of the game for Sacramento. Brent, when you played, you were one of the best passing wings in the NBA. How did you come about developing that play style, that skill of feeding others so well?
Huge influence for me, Kevin, growing up was Pistol Pete Maravich. I watched a lot of tapes, and maybe people out there remember old VHS tapes of homework basketball that Pistol Pete put out, and I watched those incessantly and went out in the driveway and tried those things, and then eventually frustrated every coach that I played for. But I had an innate ability to see the floor, some peripheral vision that I tried to use to my advantage, and I enjoyed always making the play for the next guy.
And you both came from basketball families. His dad was his coach at LSU.
That is correct. And although Press wanted Pete to shoot a lot,
mm-hmm.
and he did.
And he did. And you?
And I was more of a pass-first guy.
Yeah.
I think with my dad, he took all the shots away from his teammates. I wanted to be a better teammate.
He took a family's worth of shots, right?
That is correct. And I spent years making up for it.
Catching up on the changes for Portland. Festus Ezeli, he's jacked in for Plumlee. Davis comes in for Al-Farouq Aminu. Alan Crabb, he's jacked in for McCollum. And it's Napier in for Lillard.
Yeah, they got that one. But early on, it's really been a struggle for them to secure that defensive backboard.
Bucks over the Trailblazers, their last game a loss to the Clippers.
And just looking at the stat sheet, they gave far too many free throws away in that game. Maybe it was the noise in the building or something, but they really looked rattled.
And the most noise was being made with one of their guys at the free throw line. Those were some smart fans. They knew it was a team struggling from the free throw line, and they made it as difficult and as loud as possible.
Here's Crabb. That shot missing. And it's the Kings taking it the other way.
They couldn't put the pieces together, losing the last matchup with the Lakers.
Yeah, and the second chance points, guys, mean a lot over the course of a game. And they just had so few opportunities. And I think that was their Achilles heel.
Yeah, they were like good college players, one and done. You got to be able to make some noise on the offensive glass and keep possessions alive. They weren't able to do that.
And loving the hustle here early. I mean, they struck first on the offensive glass.
Back to Turner. Azealia screen. And it's Turner off the drive. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
And for a franchise that competed for the Western Conference Championship a number of years ago, it's really been a lot of turmoil for quite a while. I mean, the Kings have had ownership changes, coaching changes, personnel changes, front office changes. I mean, that's been the one constant, is the fact that they consistently are in change mode.
And concerning all the drama that seems to surround the Kings, you know what cures all of that? Winning.
Yeah, and the best teams in the league, they win with camaraderie. They win with integrity and trust. The Kings are knocking on the door, but they still have some ways to go.
And he can't hit the second.
And of the six NBA teams that don't share a market with another major sporting team, from baseball, football, or hockey, the Blazers have been around the longest. There's no question Portland is a basketball town. Yeah, he is sneaky at the rim, lays it in against heavy pressure.
And really nothing like a good old-fashioned throwdown to get a team going.
And Greg, they do need to get going. They wouldn't mind, you know, shaving a couple more points off that lead right away.
Yeah, they should bring out a big razor right now, Kevin. A great start, an aggressive move to show they're not going to lay down.
Barnes, and the dunk by Barnes.
And very little fight put up by the defense as he made his way to the bucket for the jam.
They did seem to take the cautious approach, Greg, when it came to defending that one. You're right.
When you're playing from behind, you cannot let your opponent have things that are that easy. And that was easy.
And it goes down 2 points. And the Blazers, an institution here, certainly in Portland. The fans, Brent, passionate and invested in this team.
Well, if I had to pick a top five place as a player to play where you're embraced in the community and where they just want to see you succeed, the positivity surrounding Portland is at the top of the list.
Yeah, a lot of whistles here early, as well as foul trouble starting to be an issue.
The Kings have shot 5 of 8 from the foul line. First one falls for. And Kufis drops them both.
Man, they are just living at the line.
Trailblazers trail by 7. Azealia screen. Now here's Crabb, guarded by McLemore. Napier dishes to Davis. Good on the shot. Davis has got his second bucket.
Here's a guy who has all the tools to be a threat inside. Davis still searching for his offensive consistency.
Here's Lawson, quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. And the rejection by Azili. The shot comes out. And we've reached the end of the first quarter. Kings lead by 5. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number 2. And now a chance to hear from point guard Damian Lillard as he explains his stoic demeanor on the floor.
I was taught to, you know, never let anybody see how you feel. I kind of just embraced it, you know, for my entire life. Just, you know, you wouldn't know if something was going on in my life or not, because as long as I'm taking care of business and doing what I need to be doing, you know, that's all that matters.
I would say we probably shouldn't expect to see Lillard starring in any reality shows about his personal life.
Lillard is a young man who is all about taking care of business.
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And for the Kings guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
Right from the start, they have been able to really own that paint and just dominate the backboard.
Control the glass, and you control the pace, and you get those extra possessions, which are huge.
We've got Mo Harkless. Azealia is out there with Davis. Then it's Alan Crabb, and it's Napier in at the point guard. That's the group on the floor for Portland. And teams try not to base their offense around isolation scoring, but it sure is a nice luxury, Brent, for a team to have players who can make something out of nothing, manufacture points.
Well, all of a sudden, Kevin, when the ball swings around and there's nothing there, that's when coaches rely on the incredible creativity and scoring ability of some of the game's best. Being able to shake their primary defender loose, cause a secondary action, and then make the play. Invaluable to have breakdown offensive players. And with the departure of LaMarcus Aldridge, the Blazers have handed the keys to the franchise over to one Damian Lillard. They've remade their roster with some young talent to complement what it is that he's about as his career moves on.
And he's good on the second. And you look at the free agent acquisitions for the Blazers, a lot of what they call second draft guys, Brent.
Well, a lot of those guys really just needing opportunities, and you have to credit their general manager to watch and scout and see how the fit would be with what Lillard and McCollum are doing on the perimeter. They've done a nice job.
That one falls.
Really led his teammate there. Never once did he have to break his stride or momentum.
Trailblazers trail by eight, and keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
With the departure of LaMarcus Aldridge to San Antonio, there's no question who Portland's franchise player is now. It's Damian Lillard, who said, "I am." People say he's not a franchise player, but I didn't make that decision. The franchise did. It's more than being the best player, especially with a young team. You're the example, and the standard is here. Kevin, he doesn't shy away from that responsibility.
No, he's built for it, D.A. Thanks.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Now here's Davis. 14 points from him the last game against the Clippers.
And he also positioned himself perfectly to grab all those rebounds, guys. Can't forget about the fundamentals.
McCollum's checked in for Crabb. There's a good screen. Here's Azili. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist.
And add a little polish to his game. Azili, nice move inside.
Wasn kicks to Caspi. The feed to Kufis. Wasson outside. Fires the three. They get it again. McLemore, the pass to Kufis. Nice fake, but the layup off the mark.
Well, the defense ready for him there in prevent mode, making sure that he didn't get a clean look at that layup. Well, he could not have been any more wide open, guys. Wow, I bet he nails that shot next time he gets a clean look.
Now here's Barnes. Wasson kicks to Caspi. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
To the inside. Davis dishes to Azili. Sacramento grabs the miss. Kufis has got four rebounds now tonight. Deflects the pass. Lawson the pass to Caspi. Back to Lawson. Baseline try. That doesn't go either for Lawson.
can't get anything to drop. I mean, the way he's going, it's probably not something he should try and shoot his way out of.
Can't keep forcing things when you're not in a great rhythm. Move the ball.
McCollum, and stolen by Kufis. And now the Kings fast break. Here's Caspi. The lead pushed to double digits.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
So for the Trailblazers, Plumlee is checked in for Festus Ezeli. Aminu comes in for Ed Davis. And Lillard subbed in for Napier. Then for the Kings, Rudy Gay's checked in for Barnes. Flavo comes in for Ben McLemore. And it's Collison in for Ty Lawson.
Well, his body control is phenomenal, and his ability to get to the line has always been impressive. That's a huge part of his game.
Now a Flavo, following the three-point attempt by C.J. McCollum. Here's the screen. Gay against Aminu. Gay, that's good. And the Kings lead by 12.
And just a little bit ragged defensively.
Not one of their better efforts, as you can tell by the score. They've been low energy for most of the night.
Just not happy with how his team is playing, and they just have been on the wrong side of this run.
Yeah, right now just getting barbecued. Maybe poor strategy, poor effort, could be both.
Sacramento making some changes. Cousins comes in for Kufis, and it's Cauley-Stein in for Caspi. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. There's the pick. Kicks it to Plumlee. And stolen by Cousins. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
The Kings have gone 8 of 13 from the free throw line. He's off on the first. Well, I hear the term glue guy a lot, Brent, in the NBA. You think it applied to guys being necessary to make a team a playoff team, to being a good teammate? When you think of glue guy, what does that conjure up in your mind?
Whenever I hear that term, Kevin, I always think about guys on the team who are able to connect the dots between the primary players, the star guys who carry a workload, all the way to what they can connect to with guys on the end of the bench. So if you're talking about a guy in the 6, 7, or 8 slot on your team that can go up to your star and say, hey, you know what, we need this from you, or you're not giving us that, and then turn around in the very same breath with the same vernacular, go to the 12th man and explain to him what his purpose is with regards to practice and preparing a team and getting them ready for competition. To me, that's a glue guy. It doesn't come about just in a game all of a sudden. This is somebody who day by day, week by week, and month by month keeps the team together.
Great explanation.
And that's how the coach would draw it up on the fast break from start to finish.
Exactly. They get out quickly, execute it to perfection.
Trailblazers trail by 13. And the rejection by Cauley-Stein. And it's out of bounds. The Trailblazers able to retain possession here. Fades and shoots, and Damian Lillard with the bucket on the assist by Mo Harkless. Kings leading now by 11. Outside Collison. Here's Cousins. Plumlee with the rebound.
He's got to be disappointed with himself on that one. He has got to knock those down.
And Lillard kicks to Aminu. He's looking for Lillard and finds him. Back to Aminu. Some nice ball movement here by the Trailblazers. 4 on the clock. Here's Harkless. That's off target. Not sure why he took that one. The Kings have gotten exactly half their shots to go down here in the second. 5 of 10. Gay dishes to Cousins. Offensive rebound. Kicks it out to Gay. Second chance shot. Pauly Stein passes to Cousins. And finally they hit one. Cousins has got the lead up to 13 now for Sacramento.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agendas.
Here's Lillard. Misses off the left iron. And Aflalo kicks to Gay. Jacks up a three. Aflalo, no good.
You can't miss those, but even the best do on occasion.
Lillard dishes to McCollum. Back to Lillard. Plumlee sets the pick for Lillard. From downtown, it's good from long range. Lillard's got 7 now in this quarter.
Yeah, his shooting has been on target here in the second frame after not being able to get anything going in the first.
Collison kicks to Gay. Lays it in without an inch of room around him. Gay's got 5.
He's one of those guys the defense always has to watch out for. Burned him there.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. Brent, I think everyone would agree that NBA players now spend more time developing their strength and athleticism than in the past. Maybe Michael Jordan was the first to really popularize that. How would you approach it if you were coming into the league now?
Well, I think every player understands that when you improve the most, Kevin, it's during the off season. And so guys either ask other players in their area who it is that they're working with and try to get together so that they have some company while they're in the gym, or they find some trainers that are going to push the limits of their potential so that in the off season they can come back next year bigger, better, and stronger for that season.
How can you play in the league now if you don't have a very comprehensive off-season schedule?
It's absolutely a year-round job, and there's some people on both coasts and in the Midwest.
Oh, wow.
Hello.
That's a beautiful jam.
Oh, that's a major league throwdown.
Keeps a tight grip on that rim, too, after the finish. And the replay, of course, presented by Kia. What a play. Collison kicks to Cousins. He feeds it to Gay.
Watch outside.
Cousins with a screen on Aminu. Gay. And Cousins throws it down.
And a few more points tacked on to their lead in the cruelest way possible.
You're right. Those putback jams sting, don't they? My goodness.
And that is a statement. We're going to keep coming at you hard, even if we've got the lead.
And, guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
Well, the Blazers signing Al-Farouq Aminu going into the last season for 4 years and $30 million looks like money well spent. For the first time in his career, he shot the ball respectably from the three-point line. That was definitely one of the big knocks in his game, but a tireless worker on the defensive end for Portland.
Harkless, the pass to Plumlee. And Lillard kicks to Aminu. McCollum outside. And a miss there on the triple. And Brent, you talk about Aminu's three-point shooting. That was a big part of his scoring, almost half of his shots coming from beyond the arc.
Well, when you play alongside two prolific scoring guards, you're going to get a lot of opportunities feet set from the three-point line. So the 3-and-D role player was something that he played to the hilt.
Lillard against Collison. Lillard outside. There's the dish to Plumlee. Kicks it out to McCollum. From deep. It's good, and that's just his third make in 10 shots. An off game for him.
Yeah, that one seemed to be just outside the building. McCollum showing off his deep, deep range.
Collison kicks to Gay. To the paint. Harkless with the steal. One-on-one here. Dishes it to Plumlee. And the rejection by Cousins. And it's out of bounds as the Portland Trailblazers retain possession. And a look here at the shot chart.
Well, you have to think that he is going to look to go to the rim a little more often
going forward because the three ball just hasn't been there. Sometimes it seems he's not getting his feet set or rushing his shooting motion, but either way, it just ain't falling.
Lillard dishes to Harkless.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Down low, it's tipped and stolen by Cousins. Here's Collison. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. Collison's got the lead up to 13 now for the Kings. Portland's gone 2 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the first. Now here's Harkless. He's covered closely. Over in the corner, Lillard. 6 on the shot clock. Poked away. Out of bounds. Portland takes possession. And a chance here now to take a look at the teams that are tops in the league and scoring points off turnovers. The Trailblazers third.
You know, when you make a mistake against this team, they make you pay. I mean, because they convert those turnovers into fast break points, and that really can be demoralizing.
A different look now for Portland. Turner's checked in for Harkless, and Krabs subbed in for C.J. McCollum. Ty Lawson, he's checked in for Sacramento. On the wing, Turner. He's guarded by Aflalo. Lawson kicks to Cauley-Stein. Turner with the steal. And now Portland on the break. Crab, good.
Well, maybe not a top-tier athlete, but Crab is capable of racing into position on the break.
Sacramento leading by 11. Lawson kicks to Cousins. And stolen by Lillard. And here we go. Trailblazers with a fast break. And, oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Plumlee, no luck.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Lawson kicks to Cauley-Stein. Lawson against Lillard. Pass to Cousins. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Gay outside. Portland grabs the miss. Aminu's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. A leaner. Cousins pulls it in. Cousins has got 9 rebounds now tonight.
And we haven't seen them get to the line as much here in the second quarter. They might be settling a tad too much offensively. I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
And he makes the first. A different look now for Portland. Azili's checked in for Plumlee. Davis comes in for Al-Farouq Aminu. And it's Napier in for Damian Lillard. Then for the Kings, Kuvis checked in for Cousins. Barnes comes in for Cauley-Stein. And it's Ben McLemore in for Aaron Aflalo. And both free throws good for Gabe. 102 left to play here in the half. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Fearless, despite the size mismatch, took it right to him.
Lawson the pass to Gay. From past the arc. No good from Lawson.
Yeah, a bit frigid to begin this one. Just can't make anything to get the game started.
And look at how quick he was to bite on the pump fake. Left his feet way too soon.
Napier kicks to Turner. Inside, Davis. That ball. Nice feed that time from Turner. Davis has got 6 points.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
The shot and game clock separated by 4. Lawson dishes to Gay. Releases. And it's Portland with the rebound.
Yeah, it's tough. His shot's been off today. Luckily, his team still has the edge in the game so far.
outside Turner. And so we conclude the first half. Kings ahead. They're up by 11. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks. Here with Coach Yeager. Coach, how do you keep control of this game going forward?
Well, we can keep them out of the paint. You can't play like you're up four touchdowns. Try to guard the basketball. They put their heads down. You can't be unaggressive. You've got to be aggressive.
Coach, we'll see if you can keep up that defensive intensity. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hi again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. A pretty close game for the Kings throughout the first quarter. At the end of one, they were able to end up with a five-point lead. The second quarter was full of highlights for them, and as their play improved, so did their lead. They'll be carrying an 11-point edge into the second half. Shaq, how did you think the Kings were playing?
The area where they impressed me the most has been on the boards. When the shot's gone up, everybody goes for it. Just a matter of maintaining that energy, playing with that same kind of aggression in the final two quarters.
Kenny, let's get your insight on Portland.
It looked like they were shooting threes blindfolded. Sometimes you could get cold, but that was atrocious. It was scary. But they also looked scattered out there, and I think that disorganization was the main issue for them missing those shots. They need to establish themselves better into a better rhythm in the second half and avoid relying so heavily on the three-point shot.
All right, that is going to wrap up our halftime report, as it's just about time for the start of the third quarter.
Well, we're getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. You look at DeMarcus Cousins in this game, he has been everywhere.
How about a double-double already? I mean, this is the sort of energy performance that just energizes your entire team.
Well, ending a game with a double-double is typically a good night. Ending the half with one, well, that's some amazing work.
Sacramento leading by 11. Getting underway here in the second half. Here's the five for Dave Yeager. Gay and Cauley-Stein fill up the forward spots. Collison is out there with Aflalo. And it's Cousins in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And the basket is good. Cousins has got the first points of the second half here for Sacramento. And for Portland, they're shooting a lackluster 38% for the game, struggling so far. McCollum kicks to Lillard. Back to McCollum. Plumlee sets the pick for McCollum. Six to shoot to the left wing. Here's Aminu. Hits it from three-point range. Aminu's got his third basket of the night right there.
Well, it's been a few years that defenses have challenged Aminu to take that shot. They may think twice tonight after seeing that.
And Cousins kicks to Gay. Passes to Collison. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
I think I saw him at the Comedy Club on Friday night. A little improv. He's having some fun out there.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
An 89% free throw shooter puts him right there among the league's best from the line.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Out of bounds, Sacramento takes possession.
Well, after Stephen Curry, Damian Lillard might be the most dangerous three-point shooter in the league at the point guard position. He has unbelievable range and extends that range when he's feeling confident.
Kings leading now by 13. Left side, Collison. He kicks to Aflalo. He can't get that one to fall. Good D by McCollum. Let's it go with a three. That one's not going to go. Now Sacramento takes it the other way. Gay passes to Collison. Nice concentration to hit the double clutch layup. Collison's got 5 points in the quarter.
And unless you have some aerial skills, you cannot pull that off.
McCollum kicks to Lillard. He's looking for Plumlee and finds him. A second chance effort. Rebound by the Kings. Cauley Stein's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Aflalo with it. Lillard picks him up. Plumlee with the steal. Shoots. Cauley Stein grabs the board. Cauley Stein's got 11 rebounds in the game.
This is turning into a slow start here in the second half. Seems like they left that offense in the locker room.
Not exactly sure what was happening there inside the heads of the players, but very frustrated they couldn't capitalize on the opportunity.
Sacramento making a switch here. Caspi's checked in. Trailblazers trail by 15. Plumlee with the screen. Here's Harkless. Portland no good that time either. For Sacramento, they've gone 3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Caspi, that's for two. Aminu grabs the miss.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
Harkless dishes to McCollum. To the left side wing. Aminu, no one around him. Portland again missing. Kings leading now by 15. Aflalo with it. Now defended by McCollum. Caspi passes to Cousins.
Just Mr. Reliable again here today, Kevin. I mean, they need his points, and he's producing.
Portland's gone 1 of 4 in three-point shots here in the third.
Timeout.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going. Started.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Now a timeout called by Portland.
Way too many shots in close, and he's got to get his guys to cut that down in terms of points in the paint.
Yeah, maybe these matchups aren't the best for his defense. I'm sure he's taking a long look right now at the bench to find some answers.
You look at DeMarcus Cousins, what a contribution.
And they simply have no answer right now for what he's doing to them. He is making them pay.
Some great shooters here. Let's check out the league leaders. Billy Cauley-Stein, number one.
He is a finisher, plain and simple. That field goal percentage just absolutely jumps out at you. It borders on astonishing.
Here's Aminu, the slam dunk by Aminu.
Most of his drives are made because of the quick first step, Aminu being very aggressive.
Kings leading now by 15. Outside Collison. Cauley Stein with the screen for Collison. Pass to Caspi. And Cousins kicks to Caspi. Unable to get that one. Now Portland takes it the other way. Here's Harkless. And off the front iron, and in it goes.
Oh, and he likes the mid-range, Jay. You have to get right up on him if you want to stop it.
Kings have gone an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. They set the pick. Collison kicks to Caspi. He dishes it to Cauley Stein. Fades back. They get it back. Outside Collison. Expanding his range. Here's Cousins. And then Cousins with the dunk.
This guy is a beast on the board.
And when he gets those second chance points, GA, he does not waste one of them.
Well, you love the NBA, but some of these guys have the DNA. He also outworks everybody. Filthy combination.
Plumlee with a screen on Collison. A three from McCollum. Good. Great play by Lillard to set it up. Lillard's got his third assist on the night.
Great fundamentals and mechanics on the catch and shoot. McCollum needs just the tiniest bit of space to get that release off.
It's tipped. To the inside. Here's Cousins. And then Cousins with the dunk.
Oh, taking it to the rack with power.
Hammering down the two-hand slam. Trailblazers trail by 14. Harkless with the bucket. Harkless has got 4 points in the quarter.
Nice job working his way inside for the high percentage look.
For Sacramento, they've gotten 6 of their 12 shots to drop for him here in the second half so far. Collison dishes to Cauley Stein. And he overshot that one, missing. Portland's gone 2 of 5 with the 3-point shot since coming out of the break. Again, McCollum missing.
You know, looking at his release and his form, it just seems like something is off, and it's affecting both his shot and, at this point, his confidence.
And Caspi kicks to Cousins. Back to Caspi. High post shot. Plumlee with the rebound. Plumlee's got rebound number 15 here tonight. And here we go. Fast break. Cousins has got it. Sacramento again missing. The Trailblazers have gone 5 of 12 from the field since the third quarter got underway. Great positioning on the putback.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
There's the pick. Collison, the pass to Cauley Stein. Kings moving the ball around. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Plumlee. And here is the shot chart as we see how things are going.
And looking at this shot chart, you can't help but feel that this entire team has played passively on offense. There has been little to nothing going on at the rim or in the paint for that matter. And when you don't attack the defense and put pressure on them down low, you are making life far too easy.
Timeout called by the Kings.
Now, you know what? I think he thinks he can make a few improvements to how things are going on right now.
Yeah, I agree. A good timeout here if that's the case. No reason to waste precious seconds to get together.
So Portland ends up going with the new group. A big group substitution here for Sacramento. Kufis checked in for Cousins. Barnes comes in for Cauley Stein. McLemore's checked in for Aaron Aflalo. And Ty Lawson subbed in for Darren Collison. They get a hand on it, and that's out of bounds. Sacramento will retain possession.
And now a quick review at the numbers for Kufis. Putting up about 10 points a night, 8 rebounds, and 2.5 blocks. And for a reserve big man, not a big drop-off when he checks in the game.
Puts it up, off the inbound. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Yeah,
two
easy
shots.
Call.
Foul. 2.
These are his 3rd and 4th free throw attempts of the game.
And on the season, you know, only shooting around 73%, so not necessarily where he'd like to be.
That one is off.
The team just cannot get into a groove from the free throw line. It's a common problem for them.
So he comes up empty at the line. Trailblazers trail by 10. Out of bounds, Sacramento takes possession. Here we are in November. Let's see how things are shaking out in the West early in the season. Look at the Trailblazers. Here in the early part of the season, they've acquired the 3rd best record in the conference. And of course, Sacramento, and they're down 4 spots from them.
And when you look at Portland, gotta be one of the feel-good stories of this NBA season. Not many people were talking about them coming into the start of the year.
No doubt about it. They're one of the top teams everyone's talking about, top to bottom. Everyone in the organization, that means front office, coaches, players, just done an outstanding job this season.
That cuts the lead to single digits. And it's 7 points for Evan Turner.
Really led his teammate there. Never once did he have to break his stride or momentum. Well, Alan Crabb was a go-to scorer at Cal, but I remember a scout saying that he plays defense in a tuxedo. I'm not sure if that was meant as a compliment. Crabb is making some major strides on the defensive end, though, and with continued minutes, we've seen continued confidence, a good 3-and-D type player who's still emerging.
Davis with a screen on Barnes. Turner dishes to Davis. And plenty of contact on the shot. So, two free throws coming up. And there's the foul that goes against Sacramento.
Well, the defender underestimates Davis's length there. And trust me, easy to do. Sends him to the line.
And Crabb making more hustle plays, trying to earn his keep.
Well, you want to see where he's gotten better. Watch his feet defensively, dramatically improved in that area. So being a two-way player, that's an asset.
And that one falls for Davis. And for a long time, the word on Ed Davis was that he had a center's game and a power forward's body. Brent, as he's added muscle, he's a pretty good fit in the middle.
Well, he can block shots and he can get some steals, and he's really upped his rebounding over the last few seasons. He gets it done on both ends, Kevin, and if you look at the numbers, he's one of the more effective centers in the league. Well, Ed Davis had a father who played in the NBA for 10 years. That does not mean that he did not work hard to get to this position. Bounced around early on in his career and buried in Memphis despite putting up good numbers when he had the chance. Nice to see him flourish in Portland.
And the Blazers signing Davis for 3 years and $20 million going into last season. Brent, that was a great pickup.
Well, he's pretty stoked to be in Portland. Shoot the two. Coach trusts him and the values of his game, and he's a good teammate. He also loves some good food, Kevin. He's like you. Portland certainly has that.
Mm-hmm. And the first one at the line is good. So he goes one for two. Trail Blazers trail by nine. Out to the wing. Fires from deep. Crabb, no good.
Yeah, man, this game would shift drastically if he was on tonight and making those shots that we normally see him hit.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
And here are the Trail Blazers now. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. They'll find themselves in the middle of this string of three straight at home. Davis sets a screen. Crabb, good. Crabb's got his second basket.
You got to know the scouting report as a defender. You can't let Crabb set up for a catch and shoot. You bury those more often than not.
And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lawson. One item that stood out, their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it makes it really hard to defend.
The shot by Turner, no good. Sacramento leading by nine to the paint. It's tipped, and that's out of bounds. Sacramento will retain possession. All right, we've got a bit of a break now, so here's a look at the league's top scoring teams. The Trailblazers third.
And how about the year they've had offensively? This is a team that can put points on the board in a hurry. Always fun to watch them play.
Now off the inbound, Caspi with the bucket. Caspi's got 11.
Now coach has to be proud on how that play turned out. Brilliant set there to get the open look.
Here's Davis. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
And if you're going to foul Davis on the shot, that's the place to do it. Don't let him get anything easy.
Portland shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight. And that one falls for Davis. Both free throws good for Davis.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
Sacramento leading by nine. Lawson outside to the inside. Here's Caspi. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. This is his third trip to the free throw line. The first free throw is good. One misses. Trailblazers trail by 10. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. It's on Ben McLemore. Well, a breakthrough year for Alan Crabb a season ago. The best shooting of his career, Brent, and doubled his minutes per game.
Yeah, wondering if those minutes also doubled his confidence. He was a great shooter at Cal, and he's showing that confidence at the NBA level. He's good at coming off of screens. He reads the defender well and moves accordingly. And he's got a couple of guards that set him up well.
That free throw missing.
And not a guy who gets to the charity stripe a ton, but overall, Crabb shoots a solid percentage from there.
Sacramento making a switch here. Gaze checked in. And the second free throw, good. Kings leading now by 9. Lawson outside. The pass to Gay. The 11-footer. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Two shots, gentlemen.
He's gone. 3 for 4 from the line.
And he buried a bunch of shots from the stripe in that last game.
First one falls for. So he hits 1 of 2 from the stripe. Trailblazers trail by 10. Out to the right wing. From deep. The offensive rebound. Azili.
And let's take a moment here to see some of the numbers for Rudy Gay. First in 3-point field goal percentage. And he's right up there in the top 20 in scoring. Certainly a force to be reckoned with offensively.
The Trailblazers have made their free throws at a pretty good clip. They've hit 8 of 10. Good on that one.
The last pick in the first round back in 2012, Azili has become a solid rotational player.
And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time. Kings leading now by 10. And McLemore kicks to Barnes. And he gets the bucket. Barnes has got his second bucket of the night.
Almost uncontested. I mean, it's nice to be able to add to the lead without having to really work for it.
They're looking like a beaten team at this point, letting him get to the basket with such little resistance.
McLemore, the pass to Lawson. Nobody near Barnes. That one falls, coming off Lawson's feet. Lawson's got 4 assists now tonight.
And the lead's not getting any smaller. Just an incredibly well-rounded performance here on the road.
And there's been a hush all night long with this crowd. You could hear literally a pin drop in the building.
Azili screen. Clock at 6. Turner dishes to Azili. Here's Davis. Kufis with the block. Here's Napier. Just couldn't take the lid off. They had their chances, but came up empty.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Count the basket. McLemore's got 4 points this quarter.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Napier kicks to Davis. Davis sets a screen. To the inside. They need this. Here's Azili. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Azili's got 6.
And using that big body to kind of carve out space, Azili loves to score off missed shots.
Lawson the pass to Gay. Over in the corner, Barnes. The shot by Lawson, wide open. And it's off from three-point range. Napier kicks to Crabb. Out of bounds, Sacramento will take possession. Kings leading now by 15. Now McLemore. 6 points for him. Here's Kufis. And again, it's Sacramento converting.
He has such a nice touch for a big man.
He gathers himself so quickly, really has a great instinct for hitting that mid-range jumper.
Here's Napier. Feeds it to Turner. 14 feet away. That one doesn't go. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Kings lead by 17. And we're coming right back after this break to get the fourth quarter underway. And let's listen to head coach Terry Stotts review the game plan with his guys.
Defensively, we got to give a little more pressure to their shots, all right? Make them make the second, third, fourth play.
That's Terry Stotts drawing the line defensively. Doesn't want the first guy with the ball to beat him.
And that's where a total effort is needed. Get back quickly, match up, call out screens, really the complete package.
And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Trailblazers trail by 17. Lillard and McCollum, the explosive backcourt pair. Harkless is out there with Davis. And it's Azili in at the 5. That's the group on the floor for Portland. And Cousins throws it down.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one-hander.
Woo, one of his favorite moves right there, guys. Oh, and the jam by Harkless.
So much talk about the game slowing down for the game's best players. Lillard composes himself, scans the court, and delivers the strike.
Collison against Lillard. Collison kicks to Cousins. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. And Damian Lillard most dangerous from the perimeter, but he's really worked on his finishing inside.
He's a superior athlete, so he's learning right now how to get his shot off on the inside with all the length and athleticism of an NBA big man. He's working on that floater, finishing through contact. I think he's making big strides. He's getting more and more confident in that area.
First free throw is good. Plumlee's checked in for Portland. And a change for Sacramento. Aflalo's checked in. And so DeMarcus Cousins nails both of them. Trailblazers trail by 19. Down low, here's Plumlee, and he banks in the layup.
Sometimes it's worth it to find a sliver. Excellent pass there.
The Kings shooting straight 49% from the field. Collison with it. Lillard picks him up. And there's a follow. That's good on the assist by Collison. Collison's got 4 assists in the game. To the middle. Davis dishes to Plumlee. Left side, Davis. Kufis with the block. And he's able to get it back. Kings leading now by 19. And Cousins kicks to a follow. He gets that one.
And without his sharp shooting, who knows where they'd be right now.
About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. Here is Lillard. Davis with a screen on Barnes. Harkless kicks to Plumlee. And it's slammed in by Plumlee.
As much as you have to admire his burst and force, I think Plumlee's aggressiveness on that play, the impressive part.
Screen by Cousins. Collison kicks to Cousins. Portland grabs the miss. Davis has got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. McCollum and the rejection by Cousins. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Cousins. The Trailblazers making a switch here. Aminu's checked in. And then for Sacramento, Cauley Stein comes in for Kufis. And it's Caspian for Matt Barnes. Now, here's Aminu. He's covered closely. They get the rebound. And the rejection by Cousins. And it's out of bounds to Portland. They'll retain possession. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Lillard with no one around. And a little luck that time, but it drops.
There's the improving mid-range game of Lillard. Just another way he can beat you.
They set the pick. Collison kicks to Cousins. And they double up Cousins. Caspi, that's for 2. Good. And it's Cousins picking up the assist. Cousins has got 4 assists in the game.
Well, had his head on a swivel and found the open man. Nice assist.
McCollum passes to Plumlee. Lays it up and banks it in. Plumlee's got 6 in the quarter. Kings leading now by 17. Collison dishes to Cousins. Let's go. Jump shot is good. Cousins has got 25 points in the game. Trailblazers have gone 5 of 11 from the field in the fourth quarter. Here's Caspi. Over McCollum. Second shot opportunity. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he can't get the first one. He hits the second from the line. You know, Brent, injury is a part of the game, but the league is being proactive, creating research partnerships with major medical companies to look at reducing stress-related tendon issues, concussion research, all of it being, I think, now looked at by the NBA and the medical side of the league.
I love the fact, Kevin, that they're using modern-day technology, not just after it is that an athlete gets injured in order to perform a procedure medically to get him back on the floor sooner. Really, what NBA teams are investing in is preventative medicine, being able to gauge what it is that players are putting themselves through, the stresses on their body, both mentally and physically, and being ahead of the curve with regards to making sure they prevent these injuries from even happening in the first place.
The science is amazing, isn't it?
Well, I was more of a math student, but yes, science is amazing, Kevin.
Trailblazers trail by 18. Lillard outside. And Plumlee kicks to Aminu. To the paint, here's McCollum. Excellent D there from Aflalo.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
But they'll get another chance.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Yeah, he absolutely refused to back down there. Crafty lay-in.
Kicks it out to McCollum. Lillard against Collison. Lillard the pass to Plumlee. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's McCollum. No good off the back of the rim.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
Trying to break that ice-cold streak, and the layup is good.
Well, as his confidence grows, McCollum gets himself into attack mode, and that's where his game goes to another level. Beautiful drive by the young phenom.
Screen by Cousins to the paint. Off the pick, a follow. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. No good on the free throw. Rudy Gay's checked in for Sacramento. And he sinks the second. Trailblazers trail by 19. Lillard outside. Unloads from nine. Score the basket. His eighth. 8 for 13 from the floor.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Lillard against Collison. And it's sent back by Plumlee. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Plumlee. Outside Collison. In it goes for the fifth time and 10 shots for him this game.
You know, you hear that A word all the time, aggressive, and sometimes just being that can turn your game around. He's been that in the second half, their go-to guy here.
Lillard against the Aflalo. Plumlee in the high post, five to shoot. Here's McCollum. The putback. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
McCollum against Collison. To the middle. Here's Cousins. No good off the front iron.
Well, the D wasn't awful, but it wasn't stifling either. He really should have made that shot.
That bucket in no time at all. 15 points for C.J. McCollum.
That gives him his second three of the half with three total for the game.
Collison against Lillard. The baseline J. Collison with another miss. Trailblazers trail by 14. Here's Harkless. And again, it's the Trailblazers from deep.
He can be just lethal from the perimeter. Even though he didn't get good looks in the first quarter, will that make right there? That could change things.
Harkless with the steal, and they're on the break. Here's McCollum. No good there, and that would have cut it to single digits. Sacramento leading by 11. And Aflalo kicks to Cousins. And then Cousins with the dunk.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. Inside. And it's Plumlee that time on the assist by McCollum. Plumlee's got 10 points in the quarter.
Yeah, this team would be in some bad shape, guys, if he wasn't scoring like this right now.
And Aflalo kicks to Collison. The feed to Cauley-Stein. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. First free throw is good. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Trailblazers trail by 13. McCollum kicks to Lillard. It's taken away by Collison. And now, in transition, it's Aflalo. Here we go. And finished off by Gay.
Oh, phenomenal alley-oop slam there.
They are taking advantage of a team that looks lost out there. Portland's gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter.
And I love the fact that he didn't have to slow down or adjust there. The pass was just timed perfectly.
Sacramento leading by 13. Collison dishes to Gay. Now here's Cauley-Stein, defended by Harkless. Shot clock at 6. Gay kicks to Aflalo. But they get it back.
Yeah, maybe a little luck, maybe a little bit of heart. Both of those at play here. He's getting every offensive rebound.
And it's still a close game. I mean, despite the fact that they've struggled to compete on the boards.
McCollum, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Lillard.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
And for the Kings, they're shooting 53% from the field in the fourth quarter. Can't ask for more than that from your offense. Collison kicks to Gay. Cousins with a screen for Gay. Off the pick, and Cousins throws it down.
Straight rim rocker.
It looked like a Greg for a second, like he might rip the cylinder loose. Trailblazers trail by 13. Stolen by Collison. Cauley-Stein passes to Aflalo.
Don't let him shoot that.
Outside Collison. And Cousins kicks to Collison. Off target with his three. And for Portland, their shooting in the fourth quarter has been efficient at 56%. The shot by Harkless, no good. Kings leading now by 13. Gay outside. Aflalo dishes to Collison. 1:22 left here in the fourth quarter. Clock at 6.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Shooting two.
The free throw drops for Gabe. We've heard a lot of talk around the league about the strain of the regular season, Brent, 82 games, putting a strain with the back-to-backs of 4 games and 5 nights.
I'm getting tired of you just talking about it, Kevin.
I'm tired of saying it.
I'm exhausted.
So what's the solution?
I really think that the preseason only needs to be 4 games. You could also do something, Kevin, with regards to training camp, where you'd have players in their first through 4 seasons come in for 10 days prior to the veterans coming into camp, the 4 preseason games, and then you're ready to go. So the NBA now, with their 22 affiliations with NBA D-League teams, have the opportunity for those guys to get in shape and learn the system going in between the big ball club and the D-League. But I think a shorter preseason schedule is on the horizon.
Excellent thoughts. Sacramento leading by 15.
And this is what they wanted. I mean, to announce their presence in this matchup with authority. Very decisive. It can definitely be considered a statement win for Sacramento.
their shot blocking turned out to give them a big advantage in this game.
Yeah, excellent defense around the rim there, Kevin. They were disciplined and focused.
And so with this win, they'll move to 6 victories on the season.
And once it becomes official, this win gives them a nice confidence boost against this team. They'll face them twice more this season. A fantastic show. And what an amazing all-around game it was for Cousins.
He did anything and everything it takes to get the job done on the offensive end tonight. There was just no tool in the shed that he did not use against his opponent. And look at that explosion of points. He was awesome.
And since the start of the fourth quarter, that three-point shot has just been there.
Well, they're doing a great job of working around the arc, locating the right shooter. That deep ball is a serious weapon right now.
And so it's Sacramento easily grabbing this one. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, DeMarcus. Congrats on the win. We know how intense you are on the floor, but it looked like tonight maybe you're having a little fun out there.
That's the thing. I'm just trying to come out here and have fun. I got a lot going for myself, and I'm too blessed to be out here frowning all the time. So I'm going to try to keep smiling on myself.
Well, it's a good look for you, man. Congrats again. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And now we'll head over to the studio with Ernie Johnson.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Hey, everybody. Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. It is time now to present our Jordan player of the game, DeMarcus Cousins.
You want to talk about domination? You want to talk about domination? This is it tonight. The combination of talent, competitive spirit was unmatched tonight. Adjustments were made by the other side, but when they made them, he adjusted right back.
I don't think anyone has come as far since entering the league as DeMarcus has. Tonight, we saw what a force he's become in the low post. He got all the moves, got the attitude, just a tremendous competitor. And he's got cool hair, too. Not that I'm looking, but it just looks pretty cool.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. For Kenny Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, for Kevin Harlan, and for the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. I hope you have a wonderful, even beyond wonderful, a spectacular, just great. I mean, see you.
Good night.